Well, I've got everything online right now, but man, I tell you, what a doozy. Let me take you through the histories and kind of walk you through my troubleshooting that I've done so far to try to make sense of this whole thing. Basically, all three of them are reading the same. So I'll go to fault number one, which is circuit one lockout. You'll see the lockout says low motor current. Circuit one was the one running. Circuit two had already locked out. Circuit three had already locked out on low motor current. And if I cycle down, we don't have any temperature differential across our barrel. So we're pulling in 47, leaving 47. Outside air was only 80. And if we keep coming down, our frequency was, we were outputting 50 hertz and our command was 50 hertz. Now it says we were actually outputting 50, but I'm not so confident that we were, and here's why. We show no amps. We do have our DC bus at 667, but we have no pressure differential. You'll see this is system one, and there is absolutely no pressure difference on any of the sensors. That's not a good thing. That would indicate to me that we are not actually rotating the compressor. If we were actually rotating the compressor, we'd have some kind of difference across this. If we continue down into temperatures, our suction temperature was still at 91 degrees, and we only had a 96 and an 83 on the discharge and oil temperatures. That's just too low. That's not what we would actually see if we were rotating. And our drain valve position is still at 0%. These systems at startup are at 0% valve so that we can have an efficient startup where we have less motor current on the compressor, and we can ease the compressor into the load by then opening the drain valve later. So all of that would indicate to me that either this logic board or the trigger board or relay board, one of the two, are causing an issue. Ultimately, I don't believe the compressor is actually rotated. I believe it says it outputted 50 hertz, never saw current on our CTs, and so nothing ever happened. Ultimately, it's very consistent. All three had the exact same conditions, and it happened over a overnight period on the weekends. I'm heavily leaning that the relay board or the trigger board is the primary issue, and it did not enable the IGBTs like it was supposed to. So they may have been getting a command signal to do something, but as far as the board was, or as far as IGBTs were concerned, the trigger board never actually activated them. But the logic board was definitely outputting the signal. What I would really like to see is the first time this happens in the log, what were our system readings upon the first fault? My problem is I don't have enough history because I only showed 10 points of history on the display. I'm gonna try to plug in and do a 232 print function through PuTTY and see if we can get more history out of that logic controller. If we can, then that's good. And what that'll mean, maybe we can see and actually see the initial fault that caused the original shutdown. Worst case scenario, at minimum, end up quoting both boards and the wiring harnesses with them if I can't 100% identify it, which is a very expensive option. I'm very much hoping I can figure out if it is one or the other. Because part of the issue here is you start getting into logic issues. So these are your main logic cards, this is your BRAM assembly, and that's your main processor. When you start having logic-based issues, or if one of these transistor circuits starts having a problem, it can be very intermittent, and it may not be as straightforward as just, oh, well, this one thing failed. So that's why right now we're running perfectly fine. We've been cycling the compressors most of the morning since we got here, and we've got the loop under control. The data center's pulled down, everything's doing fine. But what I don't know is I could leave, and in an hour, all of this start right back over again, and we're not here to see it. And that's just the problem with trying to do logic troubleshooting, is it's not easy at all.
All right, we are currently pulling in all of our data. So we'll see what this comes out to, and then we'll read through, see how much history log we have. Hopefully this will give us a little more information as to what it is we need to see. So this is gonna take a minute to print all the details out.
While this is printing, I'll show you. I've got a 9-pin 232 serial adapter just plugged into a 9-pin cable. Came up, we stripped it off. We went to TB1 for this particular board, which is the 2478 series. And that's gonna read our 232 printer output coming from the main board and all that data that it stores. And then you need pin number 2,
will go to TXD. Pin number 5 will go to ground. And then pins 4 and 8 will go to DSR. And how we tested that was we just took the pin connector, we stuck it in there with a little piece of copper, and then ohmed everything out, found out which pins were what color wire. Well, doing the print history didn't do as much as I was hoping it would. Ultimately, our history only printed the 10 that we already could see through the display. We were hoping we'd get more history out of it than that, but we didn't. So it's okay. The customer has approved both the logic and the trigger board. Without a doubt, the trigger board is bad. It was, even though the logic board was sending the signal, the trigger board was not telling the IGBTs to actually fire, but we're not confident that the logic board and the harness and the trigger board don't have other underlying issues, and this is not a customer that can afford any further intermittent failures. If they need a fix, they need a solution, they need a complete one. To recap, the ultimate thing that really queued off to us was the logic was telling it to give an output, and it was saying it was supposed to be outputting 50 hertz. But the trigger board never actually activated the IGBT so that it actually sent the voltage through the gates. So the compressors never drew current and inevitably caused the shutdown. And an update, talking to the customer, when they came and reset it the first time over the weekend, they heard the drive components click and reset, but they never heard the compressors spin over, and it immediately went right back into alarm at that time, which only further justifies what we're talking about.